You again?
Yes.
Quick, quick, quick. My friend's nose is a bit shiny. Come on over here, buddy. Come on. Come on. Can you show him where to go? Go on then. I know what you're thinking. Oh no, Craig, why did you bring Lisa the makeup girl and the horse out? I didn't. It was just that you guys arrived early before I was ready. Look, I've hardly got my clothes on. I just threw this thing on, this old tie. This suit's a little too tight. What do you think, a little too creepy?
Little bit, yeah, a little bit.
You know, when you ask the reanimated, you know, skeletal corpse if you're being a little too creepy and it says, yeah, you know you're being a little too creepy. So I'm sorry for being creepy, but, well, tonight's show is going to be great. And you know why? No, seriously, anybody? Got anything? Well, we'll give it a shot. We'll give it. We're going to try hard, aren't we?
Oh, no.
But you know, we'll do our regular thing. There'll be a fabulous, famous guests.
Yeah.
That's the best bit, actually. The guests. That's the bit I like best. I don't feel so lonely. Hey, you want to go a commercial break? Oh, how about I don't want to. Then what are you going to do? Uh-oh, naughty boy in the tight suit not going on a commercial break. Maybe naughty boy in the... All right, commercial break then. We'll be right back.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Capital One Venture Card. What's in your wallet? Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Standing right there, who was like, why are my eyes always drawn to that guy? The guy was like,
sorry about that.
Hey, it's a great day for America, everybody. Do you know what's weird, though? Remember my cold I had last week?
Yeah.
Well, it's back. It's back. Yeah, I thought it went away, hopefully, but now it's back. Holy crap. I mean, this is this thing, it's like one of those things that just, I spat a bit there. My God. I'm totally geezing out live on TV. I'm totally like, oh no, my
shoes. It's a great day for America, everybody.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's a great day. Oh, no, didn't I do that?
Yeah, you did
that. All right, yeah, yeah, yeah. I can do it again if you want. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yeah. Now, I know what you're thinking. Craig, why? Why is it a great day for America? Why? Why? Why are we talking like robots?
Why, Craig? Why?
Well, I'll tell you why. Kim Kardashian's birthday is coming up, and she says for her birthday she wants an iPhone 5. Now, an iPhone 5 and Kim Kardashian, very different, of course. One's a smooth piece of... No, I'm doing this joke, I tell you. One is a smooth piece of plastic that turns on when you swipe your finger across it. You see, you get where I'm going.
Yeah.
You get where I'm going, right? And the other one is?
An iPhone.
Oh, the iPhone, right, yeah. Do you know that, I can't believe it finally got to the end of that joke. Do you know that the pop singer, Kesha, is it Kesha or Keisha? I don't know, because she spells her name with a dollar sign. she made a startling announcement. She says she once had sex with a ghost. And I looked into it, and there's actually a scientific term for the phenomenon of having sex with a ghost. It's called getting caught masturbating. Like anyone who spells their name with a dollar sign would masturbate.
I had sex with a ghost once.
Is this a joke or is it just a real thing?
I'm just being serious.
Oh, man, this cold medication, it's really kicking in again. Awesome. You know, doctors at Johns Hopkins University were able to grow an ear under the skin of a woman's arm. That's true. The chief surgeon said, this is a major step forward in tissue regeneration. And the woman said, that's great, but I came in for a migraine. See, that was a joke right there.
Yeah.
That was another joke.
That was great.
Two jokes. Anyway, everyone, of course, talking about the presidential debate earlier on tonight. I watched it. Wow. I mean, my goodness. It was in Denver tonight. Wasn't it great? I liked the part when Mitt Romney was like, yeah, tax cuts. And Obama was like, boo, rich people. And Clinton was like, which one of y'all needs a wingman for after the debate? Personally, I think this debate was an instant classic. People are already calling it the full throttle in Colorado, the talkie in the Rockies, the ooh, that stings near Colorado Springs. That's all I got. And when I say people are calling it that, I mean, I just did it there.
The master debate in the 38th state.
Nice, nice. Now, the host of the debate tonight was Jim Lehrer. Is that how you say it, Jim Lehrer?
Yeah, Lehrer.
He's got an H in there. I mean, who does he think he is, smug bastard? He's got an H in there, Jim Lehrer. And the debate, you know, he's that dude from PBS. They got a PBS. For some reason, they chose this dude over Elmo. I think Elmo, frankly, would have been better. Elmo wants to know when we get to bomb Canada. It's a joke, it's a joke. Is it? Is it a joke?
No, it's not a joke, man.
Anyway, some people always complain that the debate moderators, you know, they're always asking gotcha questions, but I don't think they're gotcha enough. I think it should be more of a surprise. You should lull the candidate into a false sense of security and then pounce. Like you say, Mr. Romney, you say you support tax cuts for the middle class, but Team Edward or Team Jacob, answer the question. Like that.
That was awesome, man.
Yeah, it was good, wasn't it?
Yeah, I liked that.
Did I give you a fright when I did that?
Yeah, very intense.
Yeah, I gave myself a fright when I did it right there. I went to the bathroom a little bit. Yeah. Anyway, tonight, of course, was the first of the three presidential debates. Tonight's was on the domestic policy, and next one is on foreign policy. The last one is, what's the best Van Halen album? Presidential debates are a bit like a marriage. You screw up the first two, you get one more to get it right. Who? Who? You just judged me there?
You bunch of bastards.
I can't believe it's only a month away from the end of the campaign. It seems like it just started 3 years ago. You know, earlier on during the debate tonight, all I was thinking was, man, I miss Herman Cain. Now, that guy was crazy. You know, as a late-night douchebag comedian, that's what you want in a presidential candidate. You know, some guy talking sense and some other guy saying, oh, I don't know, and what the hell? I want some guy going, I'm crazy! Not that either was the perfect candidate tonight. It was a little awkward when Romney made the promise that the debate wasn't being secretly taped, and Obama looked a little confused because none of the domestic policy questions were about Kenya. Did I go too far? A little bit too far?
Scathing, man.
Scathing?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, I'm not scathing.
Yeah, you are.
Really? Skating, maybe. I'm skating, but I'm not scathing.
I think you also crapped your pants.
A little bit.
Just a little bit.
A little bit.
A little bit. A little bit. All right. We'll be right back with more Late Late Show after this break. You'll come crawling back just like you always do.
With a message for Ohio. Yeah, let's hold hands. Are you afraid? Don't be afraid. I'm only pretending. Bill Clinton here with a message for the male voters in the swing states. On November 6th, be sure to vote, okay? The next part of the message is just for the women of America. All right. Yeah, is that it? That we got. I mean, I can hang. I'm good. We don't need a script. I'll just stand here.
Uh-oh.
You ready, Jeff?
Yeah.
Let's do it. What time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
Well, I'll tell you, it's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who holds the world's record for longest week with a head cold.
Email.
And your email.
Email time. All right, this is from Chris in Suffern, New York. He says, hey, Craig and Jeff, I know you're playing Radio City, but are you going to... We do Radio... When is Radio City? Saturday? No,
the 6th, yeah.
Saturday, yeah. We're going to be there. Well, I'll be there. you're playing Radio City, but are you ever going to do a show in the Livey Live Theatre in the Palisades Mall in Nyack, New York? Fingers crossed. This is from Jim in Birmingham, Alabama. You ever been down there? You like it down there, don't you?
Beautiful. Yeah, I like to go.
What do you like about it down there?
Yeah, it's very swampy and.
It's not that swampy in Birmingham. I was surprised when I went to Birmingham. I thought it was going to be swampy. It wasn't that swampy? It's quite trim.
Found it to be quite trim, did you?
Yeah, yeah.
That's good.
Jim says, dear Craig and Jeff, I'm 19 and I was at church with my parents when a condom fell out of my wallet. What should I have said? You should have said, oh, what's a comanico? That's only if you're a Unitarian. it's a joke. Unitarians can take a joke, can't they?
Yeah, the hell, man.
This is from Jackie in Henderson, Nevada, who says, hello, players. Oh, well.
Yeah.
Hey. Hey. Ooh. What do the girls say when we walk in the club, Jeff?
Here come the players. Ooh, ooh.
And then what do they say?
They're so fun.
Jackie, it says, hello, players. We're opening a new club in Vegas this weekend. Will you guys come? Oh, we'd love to, but we're playing in Nyack. this is from Bill in New York City. He says, dear Craig, was that you I saw walking down Broadway today? If so, I really liked your sunglasses. This is Los Angeles right here, buddy. This is Los Angeles. I'm right here, and it's now. So how could I possibly be in New York today? The hell, man. This is from David in Iowa. You ever been to Iowa?
Oh, good place. Love it there.
Whereabouts in Iowa would you like to go to?
The middle part. Nice.
Yeah, what's that called? Central Iowa?
Middle Iowa, yeah.
Anyway, David, do you know David?
Oh, yeah, good friend.
Okay. Says, dear Craig and GP, could you get me the CBS executive's number? What do you think, Beth? You want to meet a guy called David in Iowa?
Sounds great.
Okay. He says, wink if you can. I think Beth's about to leave us and go and get married and live in Iowa.
I think Beth's a little easy.
Yeah? Yeah? Try cussing in front of her, you'll find out how easy she is. Not that easy. You're not that easy, Beth. No matter what the taxi drivers say. No, listen. It's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke, Beth. Yeah. Yeah, that's who's censoring me these days. What are you like?
Ooh, yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
When I'm naughty, she pixelates me.
Oh, how terrible for you.
Oh, it's so bad, it makes me want to speak like a perfect German.
Oh, is Craigie's suit too tight? Maybe take it off.
Oh, my suit's too tight. Oh. It's too tight. I want to go to Central Iowa. By the way, Central Iowa is my code name for saying have sex.
Yeah, and mine is meet me at the mall in Nyack.
Movie star with a beard. He's produced a new documentary, Side by Side, which is a video on demand and iTunes now. Please take a look at this. Please welcome Keanu Reeves, everybody. Keanu Reeves.
Crazy.
Yeah, you look sensational, man.
Well, thank you, Craig.
And that's not just the cold medication talking. I'm telling you. You look great. You got the beard going on. It's very dynamic.
Thank you very much.
No, it's good. Yeah. Are you like Robin Williams? If you grow a beard, you want an Oscar?
No.
All right. So listen, tell me about the side-by-side movie. You're interviewing James. Is he really as much of a douche as everyone says
no.
he is?
No. No, is that what they say?
No, they don't.
He's lovely. The man's a genius.
Yeah, so. Yeah. Oh, sure, he's great. Personal friend of mine. We play golf all the time. What the hell, man?
He's lovely. Side-by-side documentary about the art, science, and impact of digital cinema.
Oh, yeah.
And,
Are you for it or against it?
I'm for it and against it. I'm against it because it might be the end of film.
Yeah, I think that's bound to happen at a certain point. I mean, papyrus came to an end, you know, it'll happen. No, I'm serious, technology changes, you know, it does.
It does change, and so the documentary kind of looks into what are we gaining and what are we losing.
Do you come to any conclusions? Do you think that,
Well, I think if film goes away, we're losing a lot. The way it looks, the way it feels.
But surely, isn't it possible to recreate that with digital technology now, to make that look?
Yeah, I mean, you could put artificial grain into it. I guess you could give it a look.
Yeah.
But you're still dealing with ones and zeros. You're losing the materiality of things.
Yeah. You're talking like it's the Matrix, man.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I think there's so many things in life we're losing a kind of materiality, a haptic quality, a contact.
Are you a bit of a Luddite in that regard? Do you?
No.
You don't like new technology?
No, I love new technology. I mean, obviously what we can do with digital. I mean, in the documentary, we kind of take you through some of the, we go from like traditional film methods and right. photochemical, and then the impact of how it's changed, like how visual effects have changed.
Right.
I mean, the documentary covers, you know,
what did you shoot it on, the documentary?
Digital.
Oh, did you? Ah.
Which is okay.
Yeah, sure.
I'm not against digital.
Yeah, absolutely. It's fine.
It's just, you know, I mean, we show examples, you know, we'll give a point about visual effects, and then we'll show a film and clips, so you kind of get a real
But if you show a film on...
A film clip. I'm calling it a film, a movie, content.
All right, then, man. You still riding? You still riding bikes?
Segway. Yes.
Dude, I don't do segways. Also,
do motorcycles.
Yeah. Or have you gone digital?
That's what I'm saying. You want the real thing.
Yeah, no, I do. You ride an American bike or you ride a Japanese bike?
British.
British bike?
Yeah.
Royal Enfield?
But also, no, a Norton Commando.
Norton Commando. Yeah, I remember that.
I've also had some American iron, but do you still ride?
Yeah, well, a little bit. I know it since my last accident kind of like knocked the wind out of my sails a little bit.
What happened to you?
Yeah, I was on one of them V-rods and I tried to go around a corner.
Were you at a high rate of speed?
What's the point of being on a bike? Yeah, dude.
Thank you, doctor.
I was riding an American bike in Britain. And you know they got their windy little roads, and I had that big, that's a 600, 700 pound bike. And I was like, I'll lean and it'll be, I broke collarbone and three ribs.
Nice.
Yeah. So I was like, but every time
I ride home, or did you get the bike back up? And
are you kidding me, man? I started crying. I go back on the bike and it wasn't even working. I with the power of my mind, basically. No, I was messed up. And every time I get on a bike now, I'm kind of like, I kind of see it. It freaks me out. Yeah, you've had some bad spills, haven't you?
A couple. I mean, I broke a tooth and broke an ankle and, yeah. Well, this is pretty good, actually. That one.
Holy crackers, is that a metal plate or something?
No. I took a fender off a car.
Using your leg?
Yeah.
American car or Japanese car?
American.
That's all right, then. That's some leg you got there.
Yeah.
So you ride a British, you ride one of a Norton Commando. That's a 70s type bike, though, isn't it? Yeah. It's an old school bike. I remember that's the kind of bike I wanted when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Yeah. Beautiful. I could probably afford one now, but I'd be dead within a fortnight. Yeah. That's British for 2 weeks.
Yeah. How many stone are you?
I'm 200 pounds. What's that in stone?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
I don't know.
How many stone are you?
I don't know.
Well, where are you in pounds?
I don't know.
You don't weigh yourself? You're so wise.
Keeps me out of this. You
know? Yeah, we're out of time. You want some fruit?
No.
Don't want any fruit? What do you mean you don't like fruit?
It's dinner. I don't know. Fruit before dinner. I don't know.
You don't have to eat fruit before dinner?
No.
I think we're learning a little bit about the secret. Yeah. So you're not sure about digital or film, and you don't eat fruit before dinner. Oh, no longer the enigmatic Mr. Reeves. admit, you're a very private guy. I mean, hardly, people don't know anything about you, man. Not a thing. I thought you rode an American bike and you had proper legs. Are you very careful about that?
Yeah.
Seems wise.
Yeah.
Yeah. Me too, I never tell MD anything.
Really?
Yeah, I tell everybody everything. I'm an open book. I'm needy. You sure you don't want some fruit?
Okay.
I mean, you don't have to.
No, it was rude of me to turn that down, actually, so yeah. I'll take a pomegranate.
A pomegranate? Well, look, wait, before you look at it, there's a lot of other things there to go. Look at that. You probably like that. You ride a British bike.
Pomegranate.
They got one of them. There's one of them. Look at this. This is a little bit like your name, Keanu.
What's a Keanu?
It's a very enigmatic fruit, man. People don't really know much about it. I mean, it's very popular and the girls enjoy it, but nobody knows. I'm a bit of a wise ass sometimes, aren't I?
That's all right. That's all right.
You want to throw it a commercial break?
Yeah, sure. Let's go to a commercial break.
We'll be right back, everyone. Everybody, for that phony cheering. I nearly never turned up. I thought there was going to be a clip. Isn't there going to be a clip? Oh, it's in a minute? Oh, I got to introduce it? I've been doing this for a while now. How long have I been doing this? 9 years? 9 years. Still have no
crikey
idea why. My next guest is a biologist. He's the host of Monsters Inside Me. Jeff, I think you've seen that movie as well, haven't you? It returns to the Animal Planet on Friday, October the 5th. Why don't you take a look at this? I got kids, that happens all the time. Bug it. So, hi. Please welcome Dan Riskin, everybody. Dan Riskin.
I'm doing well.
I'm sorry, I got a bit of a clip. Oh, you like it? Yeah, it's all right.
You got a rhino?
I got a rhino. It's not a real rhino. I didn't hurt a rhino. It's not hurt, but it was made by kittens.
It's a big rhino. You know, people think that, you know, they kill rhinos because they think they're, you know, an aphrodisiac, right?
They're not, though.
They're not. But, you know, they get that idea because, you know, that looks like...
Because it looks a bit penis-y.
But
your
penis also looks very penis-y. 2.5 feet, a rhino penis. And when they mate, they can go for an hour straight, which is pretty impressive, but not the best in the whole animal.
I bet you it's impressive to you as a human, but I bet lady rhinos are like,
So let me tell you, there's a little thing that lives in Australia called Antechinus, and it looks like a little mouse with a long nose, but it's a marsupial, and rhinos are nothing compared to this guy. It's mouse-sized. They have this most incredible sex life. They have a very short mating season.
Right.
And they only have a couple days when they're going to be able to do all their mating. So the males, like, they just absolutely fill up with testosterone. They have so much sperm that it comes out of them every time they pee. They're ready to go. And then when a male gets a hold of a female, mating, these things are the size of mice. Mating is from 6 to 12 hours that they're in this. And then, like, it's so stressful for these males trying to get a female, trying to mate with her, trying to fight off all the other males, that by the end of mating season, every single male in the entire species dies of stress. Everyone. Every male. But the females are pregnant, so then there's another generation. Huh?
So, how you doing, Dan?
I've been well.
Yeah? See, you got a new show on the Animal Planet, the kid eating the cat food there. People have got kids, they've seen that before. A kid will go out and eat some cat food.
That's what makes these parasites so tricky to diagnose. Because you go to a doctor and you say, my kid won't eat any normal food and is suddenly eating cat food. The doctor's kind of like, kids do that, right?
Right.
It's hard to know. But this particular case, the kid, it was getting really bad and she wasn't putting on weight and she was starting to lose weight and she wasn't
tapeworm.
Growing. Well, they were thinking tapeworm. It turned out, I don't know if I should spoil it, but
What do you mean, spoil it?
No, I'll tell you anyway.
All right.
It turned out it was a parasite that you get from dog doo-doo.
I've heard about this.
Toxocara.
Yeah, doesn't that make you go blind?
Well, it's bad for you. I don't know exactly what it does if you keep it,
so
but
so what you're saying, Dan, sorry, hang on, I've got a cold. I was eating a lot of dog doo-doo. So what you're saying is that dog doo-doo's bad for you?
You wouldn't think it, but it apparently is.
Well, there goes my diet. Yeah, I tell you. They don't tell you that at Whole Foods when they're selling those.
That's what's so wonderful about Whole Foods, right? I mean, not Whole Foods particularly, but the whole idea of, like, everything's natural, right?
Yeah.
Because we're like, oh, it comes from nature, and nature doesn't hurt you. Yeah, nature kicks your ass.
Yes.
Yeah,
nature's
horrible. And all these parasites we feature on Monsters Inside Me, they're perfect examples of that, right? The nature, it will absolutely work you over.
But you probably have got parasites inside you that are beneficial, too, right?
Well, yeah, so this is what's fun, is that not all parasites, like, not all things that live inside you are parasites. So I'm doing Monsters Inside Me. I'm also working on a Canadian TV show called Daily Planet. And we have this big newsroom, and they're always looking for these new science stories, right?
You are Canadian, though.
I am Canadian.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, proudly. You're making jokes about invading Canada.
No, this is a joke, man.
Oh, okay. Sorry. So anyway.
No, we're not going to invade Canada. What are you talking about, Dan? Prepare. Prepare. No, we're not invading Canada.
Are you or are you not?
No, we're not.
I can't tell. Okay, I'll trust that you're not. But so anyway, working with these great people at Daily Planet, they're finding all these news stories, and there are, sometimes you have things that live inside you that are good for you. For example, yogurt, right? It's full of, like, good bacteria.
Probiotics.
Yes. Probiotics, right? So those are inside you, and they make you healthier. In fact, if you take rats that are obese, and you take the gut contents out of them, and you put them in skinny rats, those ones will get fat, and vice versa. You can take the gut contents from a skinny rat and put it into a fat rat, and they'll get skinny. Yeah.
Don't be doing that to rats.
No, but here's the best part. They were doing an experiment where they were trying to figure out what the different bacteria do, and they said, what about yogurt? And so they had some rats that they fed yogurt and some rats that they did not feed yogurt.
Did they feed the rats they didn't feed yogurt?
Well, I don't know, rat food or cat food or that food.
No, you have to know what the other food was. I mean, for the experiment.
Well, it was a control. I don't know. They matched the calories.
All right.
They didn't get yogurt. But they were measuring to see if there were any differences. And what they found, they were like, oh, the rats that eat the yogurt, they have very nice fur. And their balls are 15% bigger. So who knew, right? But it turns out that...
Well, I think I know what I'm going to pick up in the way home.
Just a good old tub of yogurt.
Yeah, no, I was going to go and get one of them rats. That is interesting.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, no, we're talking.
No, about, you do it.
Okay.
All right.
So, you know, having big balls isn't necessarily a good thing.
Oh, tell me about it.
Yeah. And not just for the reasons you're imagining. So they did there was a data set from Korea of like 17th and 18th century where it was very common for young boys to be castrated and made into eunuchs who would then work for the imperial family, and you didn't have to worry about them having sex with your wife or your kids. They would just work around the house and they didn't have balls, so it was safe. And there are these great data records for how long those eunuchs lived compared to other people, and they looked at the data set and they realized that men without balls live 15 years longer than men who have their balls. 15 years.
Just seems longer.
Fifteen years.
I mean, what do you think? I mean, 15 years. You what? You like?
Hell no.
No, man. You like TV that much? 15 more years of TV?
Yeah, hey.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. I think I'll stick with the testicles, if you know what I mean. If you get older, if you got like really old and you think,
would you get a nice 15? Yeah. I think the idea is that over the course of your lifetime, that testosterone builds up. It's not good for you. It helps you reproduce, so you need it, but it's just bad for you over the long term.
Does it make you go bald as well?
I don't know what makes you go bald. I don't know if that's a testosterone or something.
I always thought it was an excess testosterone made you a hairy body and your head went bald. Or maybe just guys grow out their hair.
Maybe. I don't know what the exact effects are. I don't know. There aren't data on how hairy those men were, just how long they lived. So.
Then it's no data I wish to study.
Yeah, then what are the data for?
Well, we're out of time. We want some fruit?
Yeah, what kind of fruit you got?
Well, we got some that'll get, you know, feed the monster inside you. I got some of that Keanu Reeves fruit right here. This fruit can ride a motorcycle.
Really? British or American?
I think probably American.
Okay.
This fruit, you don't want to give this fruit.
Is it called a Keanu? Is that what it's called?
It's called a Kiwanu, which I think really impressed Keanu Reeves that I said a fruit was a... He's really glad he came here.
Yeah, I'll take the apple.
Really?
Yeah.
Man, you deal with such exotic creatures. I thought you'd go for something
weird.
Yeah,
that's why I know to go for the ones that I'm not so
scared of. All right. How are things going in Canada, all right?
Things are great in Canada.
You got any guys at the border there right now?
No, nobody's at the border. We're
okay,
just chilling out. Oh, God. You've got so much land already. You don't need ours.
No. It's just we had an idea to put up an extension. I like Canada. You know, I got family up in Canada.
Do you?
Yeah.
Where?
Oakville, just outside Toronto.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Next time you're up there, you should come visit.
My family?
Yeah, you should come visit. Well, and me. I'm in Toronto.
I didn't know you were in Toronto. Yeah. I thought you were in Vancouver.
No, I'm in Toronto.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's good times. We have apples there. It's apple growing season. You can get some more fruit for your basket.
I didn't know that it was temperate enough to grow fruit in Canada.
No, we don't have any fruits. Just there's nothing there worth seeing.
America needs more fruit. And now I think we know where to get it. Prepare, my fruit-loving buddies. All right, we're out of time. I won't shake your hand because I'm very sneezy.
Yeah, it's too bad you're not.
I think I've got monsters living on me.
Yeah, yeah. Well,
what causes the common cold? Do you know?
It's a virus, I believe, is it not?
Yeah, I think so, but that means it's a living organism.
Viruses aren't living organisms. They're little packets of DNA or RNA wrapped in a protein shell, but they don't
sound like a taco.
They are. They're like mini tacos that get into your body, and they can't live on their own. They get into your body, and then they hijack the machinery of your body to survive. So they make copies of themselves inside your body, but they can't do any of that on their own. So a lot of people don't consider viruses a living thing. They're just these weird little protein and virus and DNA things that take over your body and make you snot a lot.
Well, I think we all learned something right there. Dan Riskin, everybody. Jeff and I are looking at the crazy sexy diet, and it says in here it includes a 21-day adventure cleanse. What do you think, buddy?
Whoa.
What do you mean, whoa?
You know what I mean.
Is that Keanu
Reeves? Let's go do it. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, all right, do it again.
Yeah, when you bite into one of those fruits,
what?
Like when you bite into the Kiwanu, it goes,
yeah, it
like
goes
this. Whoa.
Now let's do whoa as Morgan Freeman.
All right. Whoa.
All right, I'll do whoa as Michael Caine.
All right.
And then you do whoa as Matthew McConaughey.
All right, yeah.
All right. Wow.
Whoa.
All right, I'll do it as Sean Connery.
All right.
Whoa.
I'll do it as Stallone.
Okay.
Whoa.
All right, everybody.